Okay, the housekeeping rules were already covered, and we can jump straight into HMI development. And I feel like I need to be a little bit beginner-friendly, at least for a while, and explain what an HMI is. So basically, it's something which lies between a human operator and a machine or a process, and allows operator to control it effectively. If I try to generalize, I would split HMI's function into two categories. First one, to get machine-related data into HMI panel, usually by communicating with a PLC which runs a machine through some kind of communication network. And the second one, represent the data received from a machine in the most effective way for operator, showing numbers, graphs, diagrams, lists, etc. We'll cover it in an upcoming chapters. Today we'll make sure that the data from a PLC finds its way to an HMI. So I'll start with the PLC project from episode 13 of Intro to AC500. To connect CP600 HMI panel to AC500 PLC, we'll use Ethernet interface, since both have it embedded and it's by far the most efficient option to use. The first step you need to do is to right-click on the application, select Add Object, and scroll all the way down to find symbol configuration. Click Add Object and leave all the other options as a default. Symbol configuration is added, but there is nothing inside. And that's because you need to build the project with no errors first. You can do it right here in the same window. Just hit Build button. And after Automation Builder finishes compilation process, in the Symbols column, you can obviously see something from the project. Basically, every program POU with internal variables or global variable list will be represented here, like pumps control and valve control programs, as well as alarms and persistent settings lists. Suppose we want to display alarm indication on a panel. Find group alarms, expand it, and select specific alarms you need, or just select the whole group altogether. Now, there are actually two ways to connect HMI and the PLC project. You can right-click on the root element in the project tree, press Add Object, and find panel CP600 element. Then, if you double-click the panel project item, you'll be redirected to the HMI part and start with project creation. This approach will work, and you can absolutely use it, but I want to show you a slightly different one, where you have more control. First, delete what we've just added. Next, go to menu Build and click Generate Code. This action, besides other things, will create XML file in the same directory as the project file. You don't need to do it, but if you open it, you will see that it contains all the variables we have marked in the symbol configuration list. Now it's time to finally start Panel Builder. Go to File and select New. It's probably a good idea to start the HMI project somewhere close to PLC project. And as usual, give it a meaningful name. Next, software will ask you to select the specific panel you want to work with. If you have a free version of Panel Builder, which comes with Automation Builder Basic, your choice will be limited by only 3 eco panels. I have a premium edition, so the list includes all possible panels. For this relatively easy application, I think 7-inch panel would be enough. I will select CP6607, simply because I have it around. If you have only eco panels in the list, use CP607. Absolute majority of the features we touch on this course will work the same on both panels. Leave the project template with the default value and click Finish. The software will create all the necessary project structure, and that is going to be reflected in the project folder. All these folders and files are in fact your HMI project. If we would create the HMI project from Automation Builder, then each time you open the HMI part, software would unpack necessary files into temporary location, and when you close it, pack it again and attach to the PLC project. Now let's create communication link between the panel and the PLC. Go to Protocols and click this plus button. In the drop-down list, there are two options to choose from: Codesys V3 ETH or Codesys V3 Handler. The second is a recommended one because it provides authentication and encryption options. If you add it, alias would be the device name and IP address is the address of the PLC. And then user password and certificate would serve as a security mechanism. That would only work if you use user management inside the PLC. I didn't use user management in the PLC application, so I will show you how it works with Codesys V3 ETH drive, which is the same driver that would be added if you started HMI project from the automation builder. Okay, save these changes and go to tags windows. Tags is just another name for variables which are used inside the HMI project. You can see that the protocol driver is already there, but there is nothing under it. Let's fix it. Select the driver you want to add tags to. Click Import. Select Hierarchical Type. This way tags will stay grouped by lists. Select the simple configuration XML file. And at last, tick Keep Synchronized checkbox. This way, whenever you have changes to the XML file, they'll be automatically populated here in tags configuration. After you hit OK, all the tags defined in the symbol configuration file will be added. You may have noticed that added tags are grayed out. That is because we have only attached dictionary file to the driver, but not import tags to the project. But that's real easy to do. Select them and press Import Tags button. Now they are in the project. In majority of cases, you will not start developing HMI straight after you finish the PLC part, but rather keep developing both parts somehow in parallel. That means that over time, you will most probably need to pull more data from PLC to HMI. For example, I want to keep track of auto manual switches and which pump is running. We have this data in ioconfig global mapping, but that would mean that we would give direct access to physical inputs and outputs to HMI, which is considered not a good practice. Instead, I will create another variable list. Name it HMI, create a new POU which will manage HMI-related data, and then copy states of inputs and outputs to this newly created list. When that is done, I will go to Symbol Configuration window, build the project, and select everything inside HMI group. In order to update this symbol file, go to Build, Generate Code. And now, if you switch to Panel Builder, you'll see that the tags we have created are automatically populated here. You just need to click Import to add them to the project. In the next episodes, we will use these tags to build a dynamic HMI application. See you there.